serve a God that makes me understand that I am fearfully and wonderfully made. So I am not afraid to talk about my beauty. I walk with my head high because I know who I am. I am a paragon of beauty. And so are you. Beauty is not defined by the hair on your head, but instead your heart, your soul. It is not defined by your clothes, shoes, cosmetics, or society's views, like whether you're a 12 or a 6, and if you have curves and hips, designer bags and lipsticks, that's a misconception we ought to fix. Because real beauty radiates from the inside, subtle, but undeniable, able to shine through, remarkable, despite the outward appearance. So ladies, for a difference, let us cultivate our inner beauty. Let us strive to be that first Peter 3:3 kind of woman, to possess the unfading beauty of a gentle and a quiet spirit that is of great worth to God, for charm is deceptive and beauty is fleeting, but a woman who fears the Lord is to be praised. Yes, they watch her from afar and are amazed. The fire and passion of God burns inside of her, she's ablaze. Her husband and children call her blessed all her days. She is beautiful, and not just because of the way she looks, but far much more. For it's in her good works, confidence, hospitality, self-control, generosity, wisdom, honesty, hard work, modesty, passion, that her beauty sparkles so bright no amount of concealer can hide. She's clothed in strength and dignity, ties love and faithfulness around her neck like jewelry. Blessed and highly favored as Mary, bold and courageous like Deborah, a prayer warrior in the lines of Esther, a worshiper of the Most High God like Lydia from Thyatira, beautiful and intelligent as Abigail, committed and devoted as Ruth to Naomi, valiant like the five daughters of Zelophehad, loaded with the word of God like Priscilla. She is the paragon, an epitome, model, prototype, perfect example of beauty, real beauty.